how to perform a QA test scan for a GE Lightspeed 16 slice. So first thing we're going to do is click on new patient here, and our patient ID is going to be test. Click on enter. You should see quality assurance down at the bottom. And if you see your red squares there, that means you need to landmark. So let's go inside the scan room. We'll hit our laser alignment light button, and that'll power on our lasers. And it looks like we're a bit off. So let's go in, landmark there.
It looks like we're still a bit low.
Inside landmark. That's going to give us our zeros at the top, and that should get rid of our red squares. So let's go back to the and click on confirm. Now you'll see move to scan button if you're changing table locations. If not, you'll just see the start scan button eliminate. You should be good to start scanning. Let's give the rotor some time to spin up here, and then click that start button. So if you have your screen on the right side set to auto, you should be able to see your current exams here and just quickly review them just for artifact or any anomalies. Look great. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and click on the next series here. Alright, series is complete here. Let's click on next series. Confirm. Remove the scan button is illuminated. Go ahead and press that. Prep delay will be 6 seconds. Start scan. So that means we're going to wait 6 seconds before the series starts. Images look good, and as you can see, we're done with our exam here. So we can click on end exam, complete. I'm going to do my best not to violate any HIPAA rules here. So we're going to click on ImageWorks, keep it nice and zoomed in here. So ImageWorks, and then that'll change our screen over. And we can see that our ImageWorks database is right here. We can click on our top exam, and it'll come over here to this side, and you can see that we have our 4 series plus our dose report that's generated automatically. We're going to come to viewer here, and that'll bring up the viewer program. So from here, you can actually start scrolling through the images with this tab. Alternatively, you can use this tab here to scroll through your images, and then you can scroll to your next series. Focus this away. Next series, and then you can even go from exam to exam, but I'm gonna not do that here since we have patients on the schedule. I would say you can go to your first series, and that's gonna be best used for your water mean value. So we like to use image 7. We better measure here. I'm gonna take about a 400 square millimeter slice. And we're going to use that to measure all around. And as you can see, our mean is in spec. Standard spec for water mean value is plus or minus 3. we're gonna take this. We can actually get a reading here in the middle. Put it back down to 400. And then we'll get a reading up top. We'll get a reading at the bottom. We can get a reading on the right. We'll get a reading on the left. For me, another thing you can do is scroll through all the images and make sure that there's no ring artifact.